Good morning, students. We resume with the chapter Jalebis. This is from supplementary reader and the number of the chapter 8. A part of it, the introduction part of it, I had taught has quite been a long time over the since then. I think it's around 1.5 months ago I had taught this a part of it. When you take this particular, you listen to this particular lecture, go through that one first. If you have not seen and if you remember, it's okay, you can directly continue with this particular lecture. Now, the prelude of the story was that there's a boy and he's very renowned in his school because he's very famous in his school because he's a very good student and he gets a scholarship also because of his he's good in academics as well as good in behavior as well, liked by everyone. But then now he is tempted to eat something and those are jalebis. And then from house he has got money for paying his fees. And then those coins are actually tinkling and jingling in his pocket, talking to him, tempting him to go and buy jalebis for himself. Does he give up to the temptation? And if he does, what are the repercussions he faces? Let's see. We had stopped at page number 64, last paragraph. We had finished it there. Now we begin today from page number 65. The coins were so keen on being spent that day, they kept up their attempts at persuasion till their voices began to choke. See, this is exaggeration, you can say. Or you can say what you want. You're blaming actually upon the coins, saying that the coins told me to do so. And you and I both know practically it's impossible that coins can speak. So he blames it on the coins, saying that they were so keen. They wanted him to spend that money on jalebis. They kept on attempting. Persuasion means to make somebody do something what you want them to. Till their voices began to choke. They continuously kept making that sound in his pocket. When I reached home and sat on the bed, they began to speak. I went inside to have lunch and they began to shriek. To speak and to shriek over there. Me, shriek is loud crying and speaking was normal. So the volume of those coins was going higher and higher. Thoroughly fed up, I rushed out of the house barefoot and ran towards the bazaar. Now he's like, I'm fed up of these coins making noise in my pocket, so let me do what they want me to do. So he ran towards the bazaar. Terrified I was, but quickly I told the halwai to weigh a whole rupee worth of jalebis. The time at which this particular story, we talk about that era where value of rupee was a lot. So for 1 rupee you could get many things. So he goes to the bazaar and he buys 1 rupee, his entire 1 rupee worth of jalebis. His astonished look seemed to be asking. Terrified I was, but quickly I told the halwai to weigh a whole rupee worth of jalebis. His astonished look seemed to be asking where I had the hand card in which I would carry all those jalebis. Hand card means hard kadi. So he went, the vendor was wondering, how is this fellow going to carry these many jalebis back? Those were expensive, inexpensive times. 1 rupee fetched more than 20 rupees does nowadays. The halwai opened up a whole newspaper and heaved a pile of jalebis on it. So one pile of jalebis on a newspaper, that's how vendors pack things in there in the village side, countryside. Just as I was gathering up the heap in the distance, I spotted our tonga. Tonga is a horse cart, so he spotted his tonga over there. Chacha Jan was returning from court. So his uncle was returning from the court from work on that tonga. I clutched the jalebis, so he held on to the jalebis to my chest and ran into a gully so that he could hide the jalebis. When I reached a safe corner, I began to devour the jalebis. Jalebis is eat. I eat with lots of relish. and ate so many jalebis that if anyone pressed my stomach a little, jalebis would have popped out of my ears and nostrils. So he said that much I ate that it was overflowing literally in my body. Very quickly, boys from the entire neighborhood assembled in the gully. By that time, I was so pleased with my stomach full of jalebis that I got into the mood for some fun. So, it's a typical scene in the village where if you are eating something, all the kids of that particular street would look at you and then with the drooling faces, mouths over there, that humko me de ro. So, he thought that I have eaten my full love, let's have some fun. I started handing out jalebis to the children around. Delighted, they ran off jumping and screaming into the gullies. So he was so happy to give them away, though he had eaten this full first. He gave it away and these people were so happy because he had given it away and they could also eat now jalebis. Soon a whole lot of other children appeared, probably having heard the good news from the others. I dashed to the halwai and bought 1 more rupees worth of jalebis. So 2 rupees bought till now. Now this one he is spending not on himself, he is actually spending to distribute amongst the children. I dashed into the halwai and bought 1 more rupees worth of jalebis, came back and stood on the chabutara of one of the houses. Chabutara is a extended platform in front of a house where you can sit and rest, and then it's an elevation actually for your house to protect it from muddy water in case there is flood or in case there is rain. So he was distributing from there. To the, literally distributing jalebis to the children, just like the Governor Sahib used to distribute rice to the poor and needy on the Independence Day. So this is how same way Governor General used to come and distribute and everybody used to take away. So he was getting the feeling of being the Governor General. But the difference was that Governor General used to give rice and all essential commodities, and this guy was giving away jalebis. But now there was a huge mob of children around me. The beggars too launched their assault. They were trying to pounce on them and take it away. Beggars also now wanted jalebis from them. If children could be elected to the assembly, my success would have been assured that day. He said if children were allowed to vote and I would claim a political listing representation from children, then he would get the votes on that day because he had distributed so many jalebis that the children were very happy because of him. Because one little signal from my jalebi wielding hands and the mob would have been willing to kill and get killed for me. So he was feeling so, he was feeling such a lot of strength over there, such a lot of domain over the thing. Control over the situation that if I would on this particular day give a 10 people to kill or get killed for me, they would get killed for me because of distributing that jalebi. I bought jalebis for the remaining 2 rupees as well and distributed them. Then I washed my hands and mouth at the public tap and returned home, putting on such an innocent face as if I hadn't even seen the hint of a jalebi all my life. Jalebis I had gobbled up easily enough, but digesting them became another matter. If you eat so much of sugar syrup, definitely it's going to give you an upset stomach over there. With every breath came a burp. Burp would be a daka, okay? And with every burp, the danger of bringing out the jalebi onto the fear was killing me. He thought if he would take another burp, might be there was a chance of he puking. He said, it's very, very risky, but what is to be done? I'm not able to understand anything because the damage had been done. At night, I had to eat my dinner as well. He couldn't say, I can't eat my dinner. If he would say why, then people would ask him why, then he would have to tell the truth. If I hadn't eaten, I would have been asked to explain why I did not want any food. And if I had pretended illness, the doctor would have been summoned, and the doctor, after feeding my pulse, had declared, Buddha has delivered a mound of jalebis, I would simply die. So these were the things which were actually hassling his inner peace, saying that if the doctor would have been called saying that my kid is unwell, doctor would have discovered that he's eaten something a lot, that's why he's not feeling comfortable. Then again the whole family would come to know that he had eaten a good amount of jellies. So we'll stop over here.